Hi, let's talk about the structures of the liver and the gallbladder. So here we're looking at an anterior view of the abdominal cavity. We can see the diaphragm separating the abdominal cavity from the thoracic cavity. We can see here that the liver is being retracted up and away, and this gives us a view of several of the main targets of our investigation in this session. So here in the epigastric and right hypochondriac region is the liver. We can also see in close association with the visceral surface of the liver, the gallbladder. We can see the stomach here. It's the greater curvature, and that would be the lesser curvature. And in the left hypochondriac region, we can see the spleen. So turning our attention to the liver in particular, this view that we have here on the right is quite similar to what we've seen. This is another anterior view, and here we can see the right lobe of the liver, which is the most dominant. And there's the left lobe of the liver. Along here, this is the round ligament of the liver. So, ligamentum teres hepatis. And then, in association with the round ligament here, we have the falciform ligament from the previous session. The falciform ligament and the round ligament are very closely allied with one another. Over to the left here, we have a view of the visceral surface of the liver. This would be posterior, and I can tell posterior from anterior because there's this concave surface to it. So, with respect to this view, we can see still the rather large right lobe and large left lobe. And we can also see posteriorly the caudate lobe. And although it's somewhat obscured here by this gallbladder, we can see the quadrate lobe there. So the anterior lobe there is the quadrate, and the posterior is the caudate. Caudal means tail, and there is a caudate process of that caudate lobe there. Now, looking at the liver, you know that there are various sides to the liver, five of them to be precise. The major surfaces, however, are the diaphragmatic surface. The diaphragmatic surface is everything that is in communication with the diaphragm. We've got some anterior surface there, and kind of obscured from view, but we can see a little bit of it there, is the visceral surface. So, diaphragmatic surface, you don't have to be aware of the anterior surface there. That's just a bonus. And then the visceral surface is deep there. Now, again, I would turn your attention to this round ligament. It's out of place. It would be heading down towards the umbilicus in typical position, and it's heading up towards a fissure for the round ligament. And then here, tucked away on the visceral surface, is the gallbladder. Gallbladder here is its typical dark green shade. It's stained green from the biliverdin, which is the oxidized form of bilirubin. Those are the two pigments of bile. We're looking again at the visceral surface of the liver. Again, I can tell that because the concave border is there, so that would be posting posteriorly. So there's our right lobe, our left lobe, our quadrate lobe, and our caudate lobe. And nestled right in here is a very special region called the Porta Hepatis. That porta hepatis is transmitting some very important vasculature for the liver. So right there and right there, this is the left branch of the hepatic artery proper. That's the right branch of the hepatic artery proper. Here we have the hepatic portal vein, and there is the common hepatic duct, which is a portion of the biliary tree. While the round ligament has been removed, the fissure for the round ligament is there, so it would continue up through there towards the porta hepatis. And in the same sort of continuity of plane, kind of insinuating between the left lobe and the caudate lobe, is the fissure for the ligamentum venosum. That ligamentum venosum is the remnant of the ductus venosus, which is a shunt from the umbilical vein up to the inferior vena cava within the fetus. So that's going to deliver oxygen-rich blood bypassing liver circulation directly to the inferior vena cava up to the heart of the fetus. We can't see much of it, but we can see a little bit there. If this were a specimen, I'd recommend reflecting the caudate lobe from the left lobe there to see the ligamentum venosum within that fissure for the ligamentum venosum. And now finally, let's take a look at the major contents of the hepatoduodenal ligament. The hepatoduodenal ligament is the minor portion of the lesser omentum. The lesser omentum, if you recall, runs between the stomach and duodenum and the liver. So there's the hepatogastric ligament between the liver and the stomach, and then the hepatoduodenal ligament between the liver and the duodenum. So the stomach on the right here has been removed, but I'll just kind of highlight the region that we're looking at there. We can see the fissure for the round ligament there. I can see the gallbladder there. There's the falciform ligament. And within this, so coming up here, let me color code this for your enjoyment. Here's the hepatic portal system. So here's the splenic vein. Here is the superior mesenteric vein, and they're coming together just posterior to the neck of the pancreas to form the hepatic portal vein. So that portal vein is one of three major contents of the hepatoduodenal ligament. Another major content of the hepatoduodenal ligament is the hepatic artery proper. That hepatic artery proper is going to branch into right and left hepatic branches, and we're going to have the cystic artery coming off typically that left hepatic branch. And then finally, last but not least, we can go back to green here, I suppose, is going to be the common bile duct. Common bile duct comes up, and at this point, it's going to receive the cystic duct and the common hepatic duct. So we have common bile duct, the hepatic artery proper, and the hepatic portal vein. all within the hepatoduodenal ligament. So we've discussed the liver, the gallbladder, and some of the features therein. Thank you very much for your time.